Now you might be wondering, what does an OSS or BSS look like? Given these are predominantly operational tools, they're probably most synonymous with a network operations center or a NOC. These are a telco's insurance policy, the nerve center through which the network is monitored and maintained. This picture here shows the Telstra NOC. Actually, Telstra calls it a GOC or a Global Operations Center. It's really just a fancy name for a NOC. In the background, you can see an impressive video wall with data presented from a number of OSS and BSS. This one is approximately 25 meters wide by 2.5 meters tall. It's quite a big chunk of visual real estate that's used by our OSS and BSS. Believe it or not, the video walls of other NOCs can be even bigger. Also in the foreground, you see many of the workstations within the NOC, where actual operators sit in front of multiple screens. These screens typically have multiple OSS and BSS applications open at any given point in time too. This wealth of visual real estate is there for a reason. OSS, BSS process and generate huge amounts of data with updated information arriving all of the time. Operators need to pick through all of these different data points and derive insights that allow them to perform their next action, which could be helping to identify the root cause of an outage, responding to a customer complaint, connecting to devices to perform remedial activities, and or traffic engineering to route around a network fault. It could be establishing a work plan to be allocated to a team of field workers, or it could also be developing a response to a cybersecurity attack, or so much more. Depending on the application, there are many different ways of presenting the data. You'll notice that some of the information on the diagram here is presented geographically. You'll see the maps of Australia in the background. Others present data as lists of alarms, events, tickets, which are often time series by nature, as in they have timestamps. We also present data topologically via data trees and many other structures. But we'll take a look at some of those examples next. But before that, I should also note that this image was sourced from Telstra's own website. You might like to take note of the URL because it provides an interesting description of the tasks a network operator and shift manager performs on any given day. Now let's get a little bit more specific around what an OSS or BSS looks like. So we'll take a closer look at some graphical user interfaces, or GUIs. There are over 400 vendors creating OSS, BSS or similar products, and we've provided a list of them at Passionate About OSS directory. When you then combine that with the 75 or so boxes that show functionality groupings on the TAM from earlier in this video, as you can expect, there are many, many ways of presenting a GUI. I tend to categorize GUIs by the way that we present adjacencies in data, what I refer to as proximity effects. We present information by proximity to time, for example, showing log files or a list of events that are appearing propagated up from the network, potentially via time-related performance counters, such as this one on a bar chart. Both of these screenshots are from Opmantec's NMIS product line, which is open source. The next proximity is via location or geoposition. Here we're showing location on a map, whereby it's a renewable energy network, where the power links are shown in red and the comms or supervisory links are shown in blue. This map also you can drill down into to show a lot more extra information, such as within these sites there are other equipment that is also shown geographically, potentially in different buildings within a site or within racks within a building. Also, we can represent using 3D models. In this case, we've got a 3D model of a comms tower that was assembled from hundreds of photos I helped take with a drone. You'll also notice at the end of the little animated GIF that the assets are shown on this tower have been identified with boxes and colors. The next proximity is via topology or connectivity, where connections to other devices, such as this example, which shows connectivity all the way from a port on an antenna on a tower, a cable through to the remote radio unit, which is in a comms hut. That then connects through to the edge host for this mobile network, then connects through via splice cases, so an optical fiber cable is then running from the edge host through to core devices, which are shown off screen. And then we also have examples of topology of connections, such as this topological view, which is basically showing a number of devices that are attached to a comms tower. So in this case, we have a number of antenna that connect to a remote radio unit that's then attached to the tower itself. Or in these cases, where we have some of the antenna that are then connected through a combiner into the radio unit. And then we have links down from the tower into the associated comms hut nearby and into racks and into equipment. We can then show further details such as the previous links. Now, both of these screenshots that I've just shown you are from Kawaiba's products, which are also open source. Next, we can look at hierarchy. In this example, we see relationships such as from country down to site, then from site can have multiple buildings or towers or other equipment. From there, we then have within the building, we have one or more racks, and inside the racks, we have various equipment. Inside the equipment, we have a number of ports. So this shows a hierarchy of objects and the relationships above them. Now, this just shows a hierarchy of network equipment, but we also often have other hierarchies, such as attributes of an object or relationships, such as showing information that's relevant to a customer in a customer relationship management tool. We also show proximity via sequence, which is workflows, orchestration plans, and many other things. Often they're represented by BPMN terminology. And in the case that we see here, we have an example workflow in Node-RED, an open source tool from IBM. And in this case, the workflow has been prepared by David Cross and is available on a YouTube video. We also have proximity by association, and this has a number of different ways that it can be presented. So in this particular case, here on the right-hand side of screen, we have an IP address manager, which is showing pools of IP addresses. So subnets here followed by a range of IP addresses below it. But then on the left hand side of the screen, we can see how this IP address is associated to other concepts in the database. So it's associated to a physical port on an access point or a particular device. It's related to VRF instances, VLANs, and also MPLS links, where it's showing the endpoints of the MPLS link. This is also a screenshot from the Kawaiba open source tool. Now, we've just talked about some of the proximities and some examples of GUIs, but I'm sure you've seen many, many others.